Hey there, good people, it's your Crippled Critic, and this week I'm going to talk about the PlayStation 5 console and, to a lesser degree, the Spider-Man Miles Morales game. So two different consoles that have come out in the past few months, and I know a few people were wondering what I thought about them, in particular the accessibility and the PlayStation controller, the new PlayStation 5 controller. And I don't actually own either console, PlayStation 5 or Xbox Series X, but my friend has a PlayStation 5, and he brought it over so I could play a little bit. There's a lot of great new accessibility options on the PlayStation 5, and I wanted to give you a quick rundown of the console, what I thought about it, and the controller, and a little bit of Miles Morales. So I'll start with the PlayStation 5 controller. Now, I heard a lot of concerns from disabled gamers about the new design because it was such a big difference from the PlayStation 4 controller and 3 and 1 really and 2. They've all kind of had the basic shape, basic same design, but this one's a lot different. I was also really concerned because I'm so used to one controller and having muscle atrophy, it's hard to change from one thing to another, but I was surprised how well I was able to use the PlayStation 5 controller. It's got a really nice grip. The PlayStation 5 controller has all these little grooves, which actually are all the Sony PlayStation symbols if you look really close, but they're there for your hands to interact with the haptic feedback of the DualSense. But I also think they make the controller easier to grip, which is pretty nice. The PlayStation 5 controller is a little heavier than the PlayStation 4, but most of the buttons and the control sticks are in the same basic area. I didn't get a chance to try out the different settings of the adaptive triggers, but I felt them, and they were actually a little easier to press. I don't know which mode they were on exactly, but I did feel them, and they reminded me of the PlayStation 3 sort of spring trigger in the back, except that PlayStation 5 triggers are a little more solid. I understand if other disabled gamers would find motor skill impairments and may have trouble using the controller. I just personally had an easier time than I expected. I'm also aware of the news that the PlayStation 4 controllers and any other controllers in the previous generations aren't going to be compatible with this. And I've also heard that other third-party controllers aren't going to be compatible with the PlayStation 5 either. And that's unfortunate, because I know a lot of disabled gamers use these kinds of controllers in order to play the games the way they need to. Hopefully Sony will find a solution to this in the future. Heck, they could be working on their own assistive adaptive controller, just like Xbox and Nintendo Switch. Right now, they're the only company that doesn't have an assistive controller, at least when it comes to the big main consoles. Xbox have had their assistive controller for a while now, and Nintendo just released this year what they're calling the Hori Flex, which is their assistive controller, and it works about like the Xbox one. So, who knows, this could be in Sony's best interest. As far as them making an assistive controller, I have no idea, I just think it could be something they're working on. Anyway, I got to try out the controller with just one game. It was the Spider-Man Miles Morales game. It was really fun, and I was really impressed with all the new options they've put into the game. I'll be honest, the last Spider-Man game I played was on the PS2, which was really awesome. You know, open world, web swinging, and it was really fun. But this one is actually just as fun, in my opinion. I've only played for an hour, but it reminded me of that game. I am aware that this is technically a sequel to the Spider-Man game on the PS4. So there might be some accessibility options that were already in that game, but this one is still impressive. Right off the bat, I could feel the haptic feedback on the new PlayStation 5 controller. It's a strange feeling, but you can feel the different sensations on the subway. Like, you can feel the doors open and different footsteps. You can actually tell the difference between these two things. It's weird. You can hear and feel them differently, and that's really interesting. I can already see the potential for disabled gamers with visual impairments and deaf players. I will admit, during fight scenes, this sensation started to get a little distracting, but thankfully you can turn the vibration and haptic feedback completely off, if you like. Other accessibility options in Miles Morales Spider-Man include aim assist, the ability to turn down QTE response time, and completely turn off QTEs. This is really helpful because I definitely want to see the awesome cinematic, but not have to deal with the time limits for each cutscene. A really cool option that's been retooled from the first game is the ability to auto web swing. Man, this feature is awesome. Being able to web swing from building to building with very little effort, you really feel powerful when you play this. You feel like a superhero, and it's a really cool option. It made the game way easier for me to play, and I still felt powerful, so thank you to the developers. I think the only issue I had with the auto web swinging was when you transition from web swinging to combat, it's a little awkward. Like, the game wants you to be jumping when you're trying to web swing or just get to a tall building. It's really more a matter of getting used to the timing of it, but that's just a really small issue, and it's a cool option. I'm glad they included it. So this is my first impressions playing Miles Morales. And as far as the Sony PlayStation 5 console itself, I didn't get a ton of time to try out every option, though I do know they are bringing back accessibility options like text-to-speech and customizable button commands, except on PS5, now you'll be able to have individual profiles you can save for your customizable button commands, and I think that's really great. Also, a new option coming to the PlayStation 5, or on the PlayStation 5, is a screen reader, which lets deaf players type out messages and then have them read aloud to other party members. So, a lot of cool options. It was fairly easy to play, and I'm really excited to get this console myself one day once they are no longer sold out. Anyway, guys, thanks again for watching, and as always, I will see you later.